More than 300 years ago, Petrus Meindl started the shoemaking career of the Meindl family in this house in Kirchhain-Schöring. Lucas Meindl Sr. continued the shoemaking tradition of his father's and started the company of today. At the age of 19, Alphonse Meindl started to work in the family company. Quality and tradition have always been the basis of the company. He continued the heritage. Then, as now, many boots and shoes are handmade at Meindl, and attention is paid to get the highest standard of quality. Under his direction, and with his feeling and his vision, the company gained a worldwide reputation as a producer of high-quality mountaineering and trekking boots. Nowadays, his sons Lucas and Lars Meindl are running the company in the 11th generation. Production in Kirchhain-Schöring will always be an integral part of the Meindl company.
Schuhmachen ist immer noch Handarbeit.
Boots are always handmade. To produce high-quality boots, you need well-trained people, high-quality materials and, of course, the most modern machinery. We, the Meindl family, have produced boots for over 300 years here at our production in Kirchhain-Schöring. Tradition and innovation are most important to us, and they are the basis for our future. The production of high-quality boots requires accuracy, innovation and craftsmanship. Despite state-of-the-art engineering, behind every machine is a human being. The basis is the material. Only highest quality leather is used. How soft is the leather? Are the fibers of the leather strong enough? Is the smoothness of the leather sufficient? Is it not too thin? For our boots, we only use the best upper leather. Modern design and function make high demands. A boot from our company is very complicated and has up to 200 single pieces. The pattern of the upper is projected onto the leather hide and then cut on the CAD cutting table with a cutting knife. Another possibility is to cut out the pieces for the upper with cutting knives that are different for every single boot size. With hydraulic pressure, the pieces are cut from the leather hide. Now we have with this range of models a very good starting point for our Alpine group. I think that with the models White Mountain and Viper, we have a very good basis. Yes, I'm sure that we've created what we wanted to make with these two models. A very good fitting boot. Quite narrow and very comfortable to wear. An excellent rolling movement. The instructors at the Mountain Guide Training School in Chamonix have used these boots. On ice or hard routes, climbing on granite, you can be sure that these boots fit. Stitching is creating something by hand. With a lot of care and attention, the single pieces of the boot upper are put together. We're very proud here in front of a wall of boots which were made by our ancestors. Boots which are over 100 years old, made by our family. Look, if you take this boot, which was made over 110 years ago with wooden nails, glue didn't exist, trigoni nails, little stitching, and made out of one piece of leather, and the boot still exists. Double-stitched boots are still made in the same way as they have been for generations. The first seam is called the inseam. It connects the upper with the midsole. To stabilize the sole, a fiberglass insert is added to the midsole. The second seam, the so-called lock stitch seam, connects the midsole with the upper leather. The outsole is then molded into shape. Originally double-stitched boots are exceptionally durable.
zurückdenke, was dann der Vater gemacht hat.
When I look back on what our father did, as an extreme mountaineer, he did what he liked most, producing mountaineering boots. He made boots first for himself. With his passion for the mountains, Mr. Alphonse Meindl created the successful path for the company of today in the 1950s. Step by step, he developed the company, and he has made Meindl a global brand. One of our most important boots on the wall is certainly the first Gore-Tex lined boot, which our father made 25 years ago. Yes, I think it was the first step in modern mountaineering boot production. Meindl was one of the first manufacturers to use Gore-Tex. This material guarantees absolute waterproofness and air breathability. To guarantee the best quality, all the seams are checked with pressure. Only after a positive test is the material used for production. An additional test is made in a centrifuge. Water is put into the boots, and even at 9G, the boots must be waterproof. Only then is the boot waterproof, and it fulfills the Meindl quality standard. The midsole is put on to the last. The last makes the shape of the boot. The upper leather, which is smoothed by water vapor, is pulled over the last, and the rear is fixed to the midsole. This step is called mounting. Now the glue for the sole rand and the rubber rand is put on. The glue is applied by hand. The rubber rand, which protects the boot, is fixed by hand, a process which requires many years of experience. Now the boot is prepared for the fixing of the sole unit. The boots are put in a drying tunnel in order to dry them faster. The outsole is now fixed under high pressure. For the last step, the boots are finally checked for their quality, workmanship and cleanness. Here the boots get additional care products applied. Many hands put the footbeds, laces and instruction booklets into the boots. When the boots are boxed, they have gone through over 300 working steps. A real pair of Meindl boots is now ready for worldwide dispatch.
This is for me, so it is.
This, for me, is the highlight of the collection of old boots which our ancestors made. Wooden nailed and trigoni nails. But what's special is that we inherited this boot. Look at this. Somebody wore this boot his whole life, and then he decided that after his death, it should be given back to us. And this is a great pleasure for us. To have this boot now in our collection, to show what our family did 100 years ago.
Schon alles gemacht hat.